Let us estrange ourselves from the world by transporting our minds to heaven. To this end, the Most High God appeared on earth a lowly man, that he might draw to the heights those who cry to him.
The Orthodox Church can trace its lineage through its bishops back to the earliest times of Christianity. In fact, you can even read about their churches in the Bible. When Christ commanded the apostles to go and spread the gospel to all nations and to baptize all nations in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, these apostles then went out and spread the gospel and actually set up these churches. You read in the book of Acts, you read also St. Paul's letter to these churches, and you can actually see in the Bible, in the New Testament, the actual church in its embryonic stage. Well, these churches, many of them still exist. The East and West churches were united for 1,000 years. There was no difference. When the Orthodox Church and the Western Church split apart for their reasons, what we know as the Western Church, the father of the West, would be the Catholic Church. The Protestant denominations broke away from the Catholic churches. So, I mean, there's over 10,000 different denominations of Protestants who each kind of broke off from each other because they either can't agree on doctrine or for 10,000 different reasons, whereas the Orthodox Church, all of our beliefs, doctrines, are set and we all agree on them and we're all in communion with each other. And I think the continuity is one of the largest things that the Orthodox Church has, as opposed to many of the different Protestant denominations.